What is going on, guys? It's MKC Technology here, also known as MKC Gaming. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to get your Samsung Galaxy Core Prime SM-G360T1 and SM-G360T from Metro PCS and T-Mobile back to stock firmware if you have rooted your phone. But before we get started, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel now. Like for more videos, comment down below on what you think about this video, but try not to put any bad comments. With that being said, let's get started. Now, in order to get your Samsung Galaxy Core Prime back to stock firmware, if you have rooted your phone, what you want to do is open up your browser of your choice, which for me is Google Chrome. From here, what you want to do is go onto this website and create a free account. If you want to create a premium account, that's up to you, but for me, I created a free account. From here, what you're going to do is scroll down to this search bar right here and type in the model number of your phone. If you have the T-Mobile variant of the Samsung Galaxy Core Prime, what you're going to do is type in this model number, SM-G360T, and then you're going to click on this search button. Then you're going to click on this one. Then you're going to scroll down and click on the newest firmware for the T-Mobile variant of the Samsung Galaxy Core Prime, which is this one. From here, if you have a premium account, you're going to click on fast download. If you have a free account, you're going to go ahead and click on regular download. But since I have a regular account, I'm going to click on regular download. From here, you're going to click on download to confirm the download. A page is going to come up here and it's going to count down to 30 seconds all the way down to zero. Then the download is going to start downloading. But since I already have the firmware already downloaded, I'm going to cancel the download. From here, what you're going to do is go on to www.rootjunkiesdl.com. Now, Root Junkie is a guy that is on YouTube. He has his own account, so shout out to him. He does technology videos like me. So yeah, like I said, shout out to him. And so yeah, you're going to go on to his account. You're going to go onto his webpage or his server page or whatever you want to call it. You're going to go down to Android Programs and you're going to click on Android Programs. You're then going to scroll down to Odin version 3.10.6. Then you're going to click on Odin version 3.10.6. It's a zip file, so you're going to have to go ahead and unzip it. So I'm going to actually re-download the file, even though I have it downloaded already. From here, I'm going to go ahead and open it up. I think I already clicked on it. Yeah, I did. So from here, what you're going to do is close out Google, and you're going to drag the Odin file to your desktop. You're going to close WinRAR or any program you use to unzip files. If you don't have WinRAR, you could unzip the file without WinRAR, but I choose to use WinRAR. From here, you're going to open up the Odin 3.10.6 file that you put on your desktop. Then double click on this button right here. You're going to double click on this. Then you're going to close this out. From here, what you're going to do is click on the checkbox. Click on AP. And from here, you're going to find the firmware that you downloaded for your phone, whether it's the Metro PCS variant or the T-Mobile variant, which for me is on my desktop. And it's in the ADB fastboot file folder, right inside this folder right here, G360T1UVU1APG2, and so on and so forth. Then you're gonna click on the firmware. You're gonna double click on the firmware that you downloaded. It's then gonna load into Odin. Now from here, you're going to go back to the home screen of your computer. You're going to right click on the command prompt, or first you have to find the command prompt. Right click on the command prompt. Then you're going to run as administrator or run as admin. Your prompt is going to come up. Click yes. You are then going to type in ADD devices. Hit enter. From here, a prompt is going to come up and it will allow, it will ask you for ADD permissions to your phone. Well, a prompt is going to come up on your phone and it's going to ask for ADD permissions on your phone. Click on always allow, then click OK. From here, what you're going to do is type in ADB devices again, and then you, ADB devices should work on your phone. Then you're going to type in ADB reboot boot loader. Then you're going to click enter, or you're going to hit enter. Your device should then reboot into bootloader mode. You're then going to back out of the CMD or command prompt. You're going to open up Odin again. From here, you're going to unplug your device, then plug it back in. A little blue bar should come up with some wording, and it should say added, and the firmware that you have downloaded should be already loaded into Odin. From here, what you're going to do is click on start, and the process of you getting your phone back to stock firmware should be on its way. Now, by doing this, it doesn't matter if you're using Samsung Smart Switch, which is right here. It doesn't matter if you are using Samsung Smart Switch or Odin. If you want to get your phone back to stock firmware when it's rooted, it will erase everything that's on your phone due to the fact that you are putting newer, unrooted firmware on your phone. So if you're going to do this, it will erase everything because it has to have that newer, cleaner, unrooted version of Android back onto your phone. If you are trying to get the firmware back onto your phone without erasing anything, unfortunately that process is not available, or it's not there. It's going to have to erase everything. Like I said, it's going to need that newer, cleaner, unrooted version of Android to be on your phone. And also, like I said, it doesn't matter if you're using Samsung Smart Switch, it is, and it will erase everything on your phone. So yeah, that's how you get the newest firmware, or that's how you get your phone back to stock firmware if you have rooted your phone. And with that being said, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel now. Like for more videos, comment down below on what you think about this video, but try not to put any bad comments. With that being said, it's MKC Technology, also known as MKC Gaming. I'm out. Peace.